Insha'Allah Ta'ala, today I would like to share with you a very beautiful story from the lives of our pious predecessors. This story is about two of the great scholars of this ummah. One of them is the great Tabi'i, the inheritor of the knowledge of the Sahabi Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the great Imam, Al-Imam Ibrahim An-Nakhai rahimahullahu ta'ala, the Imam of Kufa. And the other scholar is his student, also one of the greatest scholars of Kufa, Al-Imam Sulaiman ibn Mihran, better known as Al-Imam Al-A'mash rahimahullahu ta'ala. Imam Ibrahim An-Nakhai rahimahullah and his student Imam Al-A'mash rahimahullah, they intended to go to the masjid. And Imam An-Nakhai rahimahullah, he had a physical flaw, which was that he was blind in one eye. And Imam A'mash rahimahullah, the word A'mash itself means someone who is very weak in his eyesight. So they both had problems with their eyesight. They intended to go to the masjid, the jami', the main mosque of Al-Kufa. And Imam Ibrahim An-Nakhai rahimahullah, he said to his student Al-A'mash, why don't you go via one path and I'll take a different route? That way we don't have to go together, because if we were to go together and we pass by the people who are slightly foolish, if they see us, they will make comments about our eyesight and then they will end up getting the sin of backbiting. So that way, if we go in two different directions, then they will be saved from this. Otherwise, if we go together, they will make comments such as, look, the blind is leading the blind, and comments such as this. Imam Al-A'mash rahimahullah, he questioned his teacher and he said, Ya Aba Imran, he said, what is the harm if we are rewarded and they are sinful? Al-Imam Ibrahim An-Nakhai rahimahullah, he replied with the reply of Iman. And it goes to show the concern that the pious predecessors had for their fellow Muslims, and how our pious predecessors always wanted goodness for their fellow Muslim brothers. He said, Subhanallah, it is better that we are safe and they are saved than for us to be rewarded and they earn sin. It is better that we are saved from their tongues and saved from their insults, and they are saved from the sin of backbiting, than we be rewarded for their backbiting and they in turn receive a sin. This is the attitude a believer should have. He should always want goodness for himself, and just as he would want to save himself from sinning, he should always strive to ensure that his Muslim brothers do not fall into sin because of himself. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the beautiful characteristics that were possessed by our noble pious predecessors. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.